welcome. You're logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com, the only portal for global Indians. We broadcast news from India, Canada, Punjab and Gujarat in English, Punjabi and Gujarati languages. And our portal and apps have a list of well-established businesses and resources that every global Indian needs. I'm Prerna Sharma and today's headlines are: In India, Prime Minister Narendra Modi will meet the Chinese President this week. And Pakistani cricketer Hasan Ali has been trolled for heckling Indian soldiers at the Wagah border. In Punjab, three passengers have been injured due to severe turbulence on an Air India flight. And four MLAs have quit the Punjab Congress posts. In Canada, G7 foreign and security ministers have discussed world issues in Toronto. And Prime Minister Justin Trudeau has ripped conservatives in a campaign-style speech. Stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com and I'll be back with all the news that's important for you from India, Canada and Punjab.
Get the mortgage that's best for you from Abdul Kaiser, Principal Broker of Ingenious Mortgages. We offer first and second mortgages and refinancing. We deal with multiple lenders. We also conduct the REMIC course and exam to become a mortgage agent in just 1 week at our location. Call us at 416-887-9196 or log on to www.ingeniousmortgages.ca.
Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from India are: Prime Minister Narendra Modi will travel to China for an informal summit meet with Chinese President Xi Jinping on April 27th to 28th. This first-of-its-kind meeting between the two top leaders will be held in Wuhan City. It is expected to add a new milestone in Sino-Indian relations. Pakistani cricketer Hasan Ali has been trolled on social media after a video showed him heckling Indian soldiers at the Attari-Wagah border. Ali can be seen copying the ranger, patting his thigh and raising his arm, and after that did his signature celebratory move that he does after taking a wicket. The BSF has decided to launch a protest. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has underlined the support the BJP had received from backward sections of the society. He noted that the party had the maximum number of elected lawmakers from OBC, Dalit and tribal communities. Modi also asserted that BJP's reach was not confined to a particular class, urban centres or North India. 16 Naxals have been killed in an encounter with the police in Maharashtra's Gadchiroli district. Director General of Police Satish Mathur congratulated the C60 team which participated in the encounter. The CPIM has unanimously re-elected Sita Ram Yechuri as its General Secretary for another 3 years. His re-election took place on the last day of the party's 22nd Congress. Yechuri said that the CPIM's first goal was to oust the BJP RSS Modi government. President Ram Nath Kovind has promulgated the Criminal Law Amendment Ordinance. This paves the way for providing stringent punishment, including death penalty for those convicted of raping girls below the age of 12 years. The Congress is awaiting the decision of Rajya Sabha Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu on an impeachment notice moved by it and other parties against CJI Deepak Mishra. The party is considering moving to the Supreme Court if the petition is rejected. Come January 1, 2019, and all motor vehicles will come fitted with tamper-proof high-security registration plates with several security features. Road Transport and Highways Minister Nitin Gadkari has said that consumers will benefit from the move and the registration or number plate will have 15 years guarantee. A record 1.75 lakh pilgrims from India will go on Hajj this year after the centre increased the pilgrims' quota for the second consecutive year. It is also for the first time that Muslim women from India will go for Hajj without a male companion. Deepika Padukone is the only Indian actor to find a spot in Time magazine's 100 Most Influential People list. Apart from Deepika, this year the list includes names like Meghan Markle, Oprah Winfrey, Satya Nadella, Virat Kohli and others. She told a leading daily that she feels humbled by the honour. Stay tuned to Indian Times Daily as the news from Punjab and Canada follows.
When you are buying or selling a house or a business, you need proper guidance. We at JP Mellon Law Firm have the knowledge and the expertise to help you close your transaction hassle-free. For all your real estate needs, give us a call. When you are buying or selling a house or a business, you need proper guidance. We at JP Mellon Law Firm have the knowledge and the expertise to help you close your transaction hassle-free. For all your real estate needs, give us a call.
Welcome back. back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from Punjab are: three passengers on board an Air India flight from Amritsar to New Delhi were injured when the aircraft encountered severe turbulence. The inner part of a passenger window fell off during the turbulence and a few overhead oxygen masks even fell open. The DGCA is investigating the incident. Four MLAs have so far quit the Punjab Congress post to protest non-inclusion in the cabinet. However, the party leaders have decided to continue with the cabinet expansion. Earlier, the MLAs had warned the party of serious consequences for ignoring SC and other backward classes. Family members of another pilgrim, Amarjeet Singh, have urged the government's help as he failed to return from Pakistan. Singh, who was part of the Sikh Jatha, did not return home even as other pilgrims have returned. Earlier, a woman member of the Jatha, Kiran Bala, too failed to return. A petition has been filed in the Punjab and Haryana High Court challenging the cabinet expansion of the state government. The plea was filed hours before the new 9 Punjab MLAs took oath as ministers. Main markets of Malerkotla remained closed recently and residents organized a protest march seeking justice for the Kathua rape victim. The residents were demanding death penalty for the accused. Different social organizations also organized several protest marches condemning the incident. Differences in the BJP were seen as the new state party president Shwet Malik visited Gurdaspur recently. Supporters of former MP Vinod Khanna and Swarang Salaria resorted to high decibel sloganeering to run down each other while welcoming Malik in the city. SAD has condemned a hike in the power tariff and has demanded a complete rollback. The opposition has termed the hike as unbearable and an inhuman burden on the common man. The SAD wants to ensure power to the industrial sector at the landing cost of 5 rupees per unit. The railway police have found bodies of a woman and a baby stuffed in a suitcase at the Dadar Amritsar Express. Police said that some passengers of the train alerted them of an abandoned suitcase emitting a rotten stench lying under a seat. The woman had head injuries while the 6-month-old baby was strangled to death. The Mohali police have arrested a 19-year-old B.Tech student from Ferozpur in the Punjabi singer Parmeesh Verma attack case. The accused Kaldeep Singh was allegedly handling the Facebook account of gangster Dilpreet Singh Dahan to issue threats for extortion. Additional Solicitor General of India Satyapal Jain has asked the Union Government to amend the law provisions for enabling stricter punishment for chain snatchers in Chandigarh. The city has been a victim of snatchers who are striking at will, targeting mostly women. I'll be back. Stay logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com as the news from Canada follows. Scans
Accountant. A team of highly professional accountants, we deliver quality and immeasurable assistance to our clients. For Canada audit assistance and your business loans, the only name you can trust. A professional accountant always makes a difference. For more information, call us at 416-741-0801 or visit us at scansaccountants.com.
Welcome back to IndianTimesDaily.com. And the top 10 headlines from Canada are: G7 Foreign and Security Ministers got underway in Toronto on Sunday, with Foreign Affairs Minister Chrystia Freeland inviting her counterparts to discuss world troubles. The special outreach session involved meeting a series of non-G7 foreign ministers who are women. Prime Minister Justin Trudeau has taken a sharp aim at his chief electoral opponent, casting Andrew Scheer as a divisive force in a campaign-style speech to fire up his troops in Halifax. With 18 months to go for the 2019 election, Trudeau asked supporters to help the Liberal government win re-election. Ontario NDP leader Andrew Horwath has stated that PC leader Doug Ford will manage an easy victory in the upcoming Ontario election. Horwath said that there's no need to fear a split in progressive voters as they've already made up their minds not to vote for Liberal Premier Kathleen Wynne. The Halifax police are investigating an alleged sexual assault that reportedly involved an Ontario Liberal MP in Halifax attending the National Liberal Convention. Liberal MP Francis Drouin confirmed that he was the subject of allegation but didn't mention the incident occurred. Alberta's UCP leader Jason Kenney has called the Kinder-Morgan pipeline battle as a complete violation of Canadian Economic Union. Kenney stated that the pipeline battle is tearing at the seams of the vision of Canada pursued by the fathers of Confederation. Finance Minister Bill Morneau stated that the federal government cannot offer a timeline for getting the Trans Mountain Pipeline extension built. Morneau said that the government sees advantages in getting the pipeline built rapidly, which will allow more Canadian oil to be sold in the international markets. The NDP has demanded the lobbying commissioner to investigate whether Facebook is finding ways around the rules to register its lobbyists. Facebook has said they will join Canada's registry of lobbyists after questions were raised over its approach to lobbying the government. Inflation rates are likely to hover just above the historic target of 2% for the entire year. Canada's central bank governor noted the longer-term trend line as steady. Canada has announced its highest inflation level in several years, following a period of lower numbers after the oil price collapse. Doug Ford has appointed 11 progressive conservative candidates to run in the June 7th election, including the son of former Ontario Premier Mike Harris. The appointment came despite the fact that Harris Jr. lost the nomination battle to Dan Weber in the neighbouring riding of Waterloo. One of the central figures in an ethics scandal involving Prime Minister Justin Trudeau is Smiley spiritual leader Aga Khan is set to visit Canada to celebrate his Diamond Jubilee. Trudeau has come under fire for taking a vacation to a private island owned by the Aga Khan over the last year. This is the end of the news bulletin, but stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Bollywood is coming up next. And do visit the resources section on this portal to find the best Indo-Canadian businesses and resources, from accounting firms to wedding planners in your city. All of us at Indian Times Daily wish that you have a great day.
Welcome to the Field Fresh Supermarket. One-stop shop for fresh vegetables, fruits, bakery products, Indian and Chinese grocery and much more. Visit us today at 5661 Steeles Avenue East in Scarborough, major intersection Steeles and Middlefield. Check out our weekly flyers. Field Fresh Supermarket, always fresh.
Acclaimed filmmaker Rajkumar Hirani, who is busy with the post-production of his upcoming film Sanju, featuring actor Ranbir Kapoor, has confirmed that the film's teaser will be released on Tuesday morning. Refuting news of its release during an IPL match on April 24th, Hirani said,
That's not a correct news. Yes, sir. IPL mein chalaya ja raha hai, as far as I understand, which is, hum log launch uske pehle kar rahe hain, 24 ko subah. सुबह हम लोग लॉन्च करने वाले हैं. आई थिंक अभी अनाउंस हो जाएगा. आप हो कि आप बोल दिया तो 24 को हम लोग सुबह करेंगे और शाम को वहाँ पे चला जाएगा.
There were reports earlier that Hirani would release the first look of the biopic on Sanjay Dutt before the April 24th IPL clash, and a teaser would be shown in the presence of Ranbir and Sanjay on a cricket live show on Star Sports. When asked whether Sanju would help to re-establish Ranbir again, the Three Idiots and PK director said, Sanju is a biographical drama written and directed by Rajkumar Hirani and produced by Vidhu Vinod Chopra. The film is based on the life of actor Sanjay Dutt, with Ranbir Kapoor portraying the role. Sanju is set to be released on June 29th.
Immigration Terminal, the specialist for visitor visa, student visa, business immigration, family sponsorship, work permits, PNP programs, live-in caregivers and LMIA applications. Highly experienced in cases involving criminal or medical admissibility and previously refused or misrepresentation cases. Call 416-675-5666 in Ontario or 778-927-3455 in BC. Email us at info@immigrationterminal.ca. Immigration Terminal, right consultants, right future.
Comedian actor Sunil Grover, who has backed a role in superstar Salman Khan Star of Bharat, says he is proud to be a part of the project. The film's director Ali Abbas Zafar welcomed Sunil to his film's cast, headlined by Salman Khan and Priyanka Chopra. "Welcome Sunil Grover to Bharat," Zafar tweeted. Sunil replied, "Thank you, sir, for giving me the visa. I am so proud of being part of this project." The film is an official adaptation of 2014 South Korean film Ode to My Father. Bharat is scheduled to release on Eid 2019.
Karol Bagh Jewelers, gehniyan de latest design layi pehli choice. Sone ate hire de set, chudiyan ate kade, chain, jadau set ate hor vi kai gehniyan te special discount. Sab to vaddi choice, behtareen service ate sab to wajib rate layi aao Karol Bagh Jewelers ate Roop Jewelers. Karol Bagh Jewelers, 1098 पीटर रॉबर्टसन बुलेवार्ड ब्रैम्पटन रूप ज्वेलर्स 503 रे लॉसन बुलेवार्ड ब्रैम्पटन